In this video, we'll be configuring our NVChad, the NeoVim config that we've already worked on. We will be adding Odin support. This is going to be a pretty quick, simple video, so let's just dive into it. If you want to follow along with this video, go to github.com/programmingrainbow/NVChad, and this is the 2.5 version of NVChad. And this has a whole page talking about how to, and the videos that go with it, that talk about configuring NVChad, and then it has adding different language support like C++, Go, there's some Pythons, and then down closer to the bottom there is Odin, which I'm covering right here in this video, and Haskell. And there'll be more as I add to it. Let's look at a project that I have right here. It is the one that we've already worked on in a prior video. So I'm going to open it up, open up my Odin file. And it looks like I have a little bit of syntax highlighting, but I don't really have much. It's not the proper syntax highlighting that TreeSitter can give us. So obviously we could just put here TS install Odin. We could do that. But I actually want to put it into the configuration, because anytime I want to move my configuration to another computer or anything else, it's already going to be there if I need to redo it. So I don't need to remember to type it in each time. So I'm going to put it in the configuration, but you could do it either way. I'll just show you. TS install, and Odin is going to install it. And that gives us the colors just changed, and now we have proper syntax highlighting. I'm going to remove it. TS uninstall, just so I can show that it works through the configuration. I'm going to open up another Scratch window. It's just another terminal. It's just easier for me to do that. I can just bring this one open and close. So that's all I'm doing. It's just another terminal. So in your local directory, .config/nvim, I'm just going to add that. I do kind of want to show that NVChad made a change. And this right here, this m.base46 used to be m.ui. So if you try to change your theme and you're using myconfig, you're going to need to either repull my config that has been updated now, or you're going to need to change that UI to base 46. If it's base 46, it'll work again. Okay, so let's go into config here, onto treesitter.lua, and we can just add it in alphabetical order. So I'll just put it here. And it's just Odin. Okay, so now if we restart either one of these, I'm just going to close that. I'm going to restart this one here. I think I made a change to my buffer. That's fine. Okay, so now when we go into this file, it should start pulling down TreeSitter. Yep, there we go. And now we got it. So that is our syntax highlighting. And the great thing is everything else is actually just one package. To get us our LSP, to give us our linting, to give us our formatting, is actually in here. And this is just the Odin language server. And I didn't need to configure anything to get this working. It just worked out of the box. It's very simple. So let's just open up our... So this is already saved here. I'm going to go over to the lspconf.lua. This is where we deal with language servers. And I want it to install the language servers for me. So I'm going to add it to this list up here. This list is just a way for Mason to automatically download and install a language server. So I'm just going to add one here. And this is Odin language server. So it's OLS. And I'm going to add a comma there. And then down here in the default servers, so this up here is just going to download it for us, but it's not going to set it up to use it. So like I said, it was very simple for me. I just used the default configuration. So right here, anything I add here is going to be configured with this block down here that just applies the default configuration. So down here in Lua, we made our own like special configuration. But we don't need to, I didn't need to do at least anything special for this. It just worked out of the box. So I'm just going to use this default one here. So I'm going to add OLS here. And that should download and compile it for me, and then set it up to use it for me. Now, again, it just did everything I wanted out of the box, but if you find it's not doing something, or if I've missed something, or you need to configure it slightly differently, go ahead and share that information in the comments or in the GitHub repository so that everybody else can have that information too, because it may be I've missed something here. Like I said, it's just worked for me, but I could just be missing some simple things where we do need to create something like this. But for right now, for what I was doing, using this default block and just putting it here so that this default block gets run on it is all I needed to do. So I'm going to save this. Just going to get rid of that scratch window real quick, and I'm going to reload this. And we're going to see right down here, we're going to see it's going to say OLS when I restart it. Down here, it's downloading it. It's installed it. Now, if I open up a file. Okay, we have a language server running here, OLS. So let's see if we can get some language server things going on. So here's free music. Let's see if we can get the language server to give us our signature for this. Let's see, I always forget it. It's not doing it for that. Should do it for it. Try something else. Oh, there we go. Does it for that. I'm not sure why it didn't do it earlier, but here is the signature for the ePrint FLF line. Let me try that again on the other one. Oh, I'm not sure what it was. Maybe I was just doing it on the wrong one. Okay, so this is giving us a signature. What if we want to go to definition? We can do this again. So we've gone to the definition. That works. We can mess up some code here. And we have linting happening. That's great. I'm going to undo that. What if our formatting wasn't formatted correctly? Let me not that one. What's going on here? Okay. Yeah, it looks like this one isn't formatted correctly. And it did fix it. Make sure. Oh, I see. I accidentally deleted a character there. So this one right here is what I'm looking at right here. I accidentally deleted the S down here when I was trying to do the signature to show the signature. But right here, this guy should be indented. So I'm going to control W on it to save it, and it's going to automatically format. And that's fixed it. Okay. So we have linting, we have formatting, we have the language server support. It's telling me I have another error down here. Where is it at? Oh, no, it's gone away now. Okay. So like I said, I didn't really need to do anything. It just kind of worked for me. But again, I could be missing something. I haven't done a huge amount of Odin programming, but it seems to work pretty good. So if you are, you know, like I said, have anything that I missed, please add it to this video or add it to the GitHub, you know, in the GitHub repository so that everybody can have access to that. I also want to show you real quick that I've already kind of added this stuff in, but I've commented it out. So if we pull this up again, I'm just going to close this. And I'm going to change out this directory, and I'm just going to nuke my nvim. So the local share, yeah, let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of the cache. Should be right here. Not sure why it's okay. And also the actual config. Okay, so that's all gone now. So I'm just going to close this and restart it. Well, I'm not even going to restart it. It's just not going to have anything there. You know, it's just going to be a stock NeoVim. It's not going to be NVChat at all. And nothing will happen. So what we need to do is we need to actually get the back from the github.com programming rainbow, you know, all that, the NVChat too. So it's going to look like this. Git clone HTTPS. And this one is going to be nvchad 2.5. And then we're telling it, it's going to get rid of this a bit. We're telling it we want this repository to be cloned in our local hidden config in nvim. Okay, so there should be nothing in there right now. So that's going to clone that. Now we don't need some things in here. If I just show what's in this folder real quick, or directory. There's a couple things we don't need. We don't need .get at all. Also, you don't need these screenshots. So you could get rid of these screenshots and this .get right away. So I'm gonna rm rf and the .get, and then I'm just gonna I don't think I need the rm rf here. Okay. So, you know, like I said, you didn't need those things. So now when I start this up, this thing should totally build itself as it should. Okay, so we're just building, it's just completely configuring NVChat right now. Like Lua check has done, it's probably done now. So let's go in, and now we're not going to have anything again because we've lost our syntax highlighting and stuff. But I just want to show you what this looks like now. So when we go into tree sitter. I've actually put in all the things that I've made, all the videos that I've done, I've put them in. So you don't need to remember the name of it. You can just go down to Odin and uncomment it and save it. And then for Odin, all you need to do is go into LSP config right here. And we see OLS is right here. Uncomment that. And we see OLS is here. Uncomment that. Okay. And so if we just restart this one now, it's going to install OLS and the tree sitter as well, and we'll be back where we were before. There we go, there's tree sitter, and let's see if our language server is working. Yep, looks pretty good. Basically, there's only two things going on here. There is tree sitter just to give us our syntax highlighting, and the LSP config is giving us our Odin language server. And I'm just using the default. So pretty simple, pretty easy going. That's going to be pretty much it for this video. There is the GitHub for OLS here. Again, there's my page that has these instructions and for other languages too. And again, share if there's any issues. I'll do what I can if I can figure out what it is that's the problem. Okay. So that's going to be all for this one. And thanks for watching and have a good day. Bye.